إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. All the praise due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him. And whomever misguide, no one will guide him. I bear witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty. And Muhammad is the last and final messenger. We thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deeply all the time. The one He give us the knowledge and give us the brain to think. The one He send the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a man of mercy for all whole of the world. Today inshallah we continue the series of the description of the people of paradise. And today by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are in the sifatu, the attribute number three. The attribute number three from the attributes of the people of al-Jannah, the people of paradise, the people of heaven, the people of success, the people of happy, in the last destination in the hereafter. الجنة وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. Compete and be fast and hurry and run إلى مغفرة من ربكم, to achieve the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and جنة, gardens, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ, the width of this garden, the width of heaven and paradise, like the heaven and the earth. Allahu Akbar. What an amazing description of the people of Jannah. We have to work hard to achieve. And how we work hard? We need to know the صِفَاتُ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, the attribute, the quality, the character of the people of Jannah. When we achieve it, inshallah, we are in the right way. We are in the way of Jannah. Today, this attribute, what? عدم استجابة لقرناء السوء. عدم الاستجابة إلى قرناء السوء. They will not answer the call from bad friends. They are avoiding the bad friends. This is the character of the people of Jannah. They are far away, they run away. They are avoiding the bad friends. And today, inshallah, by the will of Allah, after you hear the ayat and the hadith and the story, you will be amazed how evil the bad friends, how they can stop your way, how they are disgusting in your way of your to achieve the Jannah. Subhanallah, bad friend, very evil, very bad. Always doesn't want you to be in the right track. They feel hatred if you are in the truth. They feel uncomfort if you are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These bad friends, they kept the hatred for the Salihin inside their heart. And always they put the spike, and always they put the rubbish, the things in the front of the way of the people of As-Salihin, the pious people. Let's find out from the ayat of Al-Quran and from the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First verses we would like to share with you from Surah As-Saffat, Ayah number 33 to ayah number 61. So many ayat is contain story, contain reminder. Let's find out this ayat. قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فإنهم يومئذ في العذاب مشتركون إنا كذلك نفعل بالمجرمين إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله يستكبرون ويقولون أئنا لتاركو آلهتنا لشاعر مجنون بل جاء بالحق وصدق المرسلين إنكم لذائق العذاب الأليم وما تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون. In this ayat, فإنهم يومئذ في العذاب مشتركون. We start in this ayat.
So indeed they, that day, will be sharing in the punishment.
فإنهم يومئذ في العذاب مشتركون إنا كذلك نفعل بالمجرمين. This ayat, إنا كذلك نفعل بالمجرمين إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله يستكبرون. In this ayat, Allah سبحانه وتعالى described the criminals, المجرمون. قال تعالى إنا كذلك نفعل بالمجرمين. The criminals, the bad people, what they used to do. إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله يستكبرون. When those criminals hear the word of لا إله إلا الله, what will happen to them? They will feel proud on themselves. They have a pride. They are ignorant. They are turned away from لا إله إلا الله. يستكبرون. ويقولون أئنا لتاركو آلهتنا لشاعر مجنون. Not only they avoid the truth. Look what they are doing. They start attacking the people of the truth. They start attacking the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم by saying what? إنهم لتاركو آلهتنا لشاعر مجنون. Who is this man? He's saying like a poem, like a crazy. They call the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's a crazy. What kind of poem he's saying? Foolish one. Okay? بل جاء بالحق وصدق المرسلين إنكم لذائق العذاب الأليم وما تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared that whatever Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم brought is from the truth. بل جاء بالحق. He brought the truth. إنكم لذائق العذاب الأليم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning them severely punishment. عذاب أليم. وما تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إلا عباد الله المخلصين. Except the عباد الله المخلصين. Except the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whom they have ikhlas. Or whom they are selected by Allah to be saved from those people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in this surah the people of Ibadullah, the servant of Allah, al-mukhlisin, by saying, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ رِزْقٌ مَعْلُومٌ فَوَاكِهُ وَهُمْ مُكْرَمُونَ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. Those, they will have so much rizq, so much happiness. Allah will provide for them whatever they wish and whatever they hope. رِزْقٌ مَعْلُومٌ فَوَاكِهُ, fruits. وَهُمْ مُكْرَمُونَ, they will be honored. فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ, in gardens, not garden, gardens. فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep describing the people of Jannah, how they will enjoy, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide for them the fruit and the food from Jannah, and also the Hur al-Ain, the wife in Jannah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing in many ayat, the people, how they are, the enjoyment of the people of Jannah. Where is the witness relate to our topic? From the ayah number 51. So in the ayah 51, In ayah 51, قال تعالى قال قائل منهم إني كان لي قرين. قال تعالى قال تعالى describing the amazing story. قال قائل منهم إني كان لي قرين. One person, subhanAllah, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first of all, Allah described the criminals, then the people in Jannah, they are enjoyment. While they are enjoyment, one of them, he spoke loudly, openly, he said, قال قائل منهم إني كان لي قرين. I had a friend. I had a friend. إني كان لي قرين. Very close friend. He is looking around where he is. يقول أئنك لمن المصدقين. يقول أئنك لمن المصدقين. أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون. Allah, this person, subhanAllah, he look around, where is my close friend is? Then he start remember. إني كان لي قرين يقول أئنك لمن المصدقين أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون. And he start remember amazing conversation between that person, the one in Jannah, and with his close friend in the dunya time. I had a qareen, Allahu Akbar, where he is? One time I had discussion with him. I had a dialogue with him. يقول أئنك لمن المصدقين. Are you among of the believer? أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا أئنا لا مبعوثون. أئنا لا أئنا لا مبعوثون أو آباؤنا الأولون. Subhanallah, in this conversation they are talking to each other and they are thinking, ah, Allahu Akbar, I had conversation with him. He told me that are you among of the believer of the Ba'ath and Nushur? Your resurrection day will be resurrected. Subhanallah, after that, he looked at around. أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ أَوَآبَاؤُنَا الْأَوَّلُونَ قُلْ نَعَمْ وَأَنْتُمْ دَاخِرُونَ. Then he continued in the ayat. This is the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about this person. Then while he's looking around, suddenly he found him where? فَاطَّلَعَ فَرَآهُ فِي سَوَاءِ الْجَحِيمِ. He saw him in the middle of the hellfire. Then subhanAllah, he shocked. قالت الله إن كدت لتردين ولولا نعمة ربي لكنت من المحضرين ولولا نعمة ربي لكنت من المحضرين. الله أكبر. What an amazing آيات. So touching verses. قال تعالى ولولا نعمة ربي. That person, the one he is in Jannah, Ya Allah, when he saw him in the middle of the punishment, by the will of Allah, and ni'mah of Allah, and the bounty of Allah, I will be now with you in the middle of the hellfire, wal-'iyadhu billah. Why? What is the story? That person, the bad one, he told him, why you believe in the resurrection day? Are you among of the believer? Don't believe nothing. We will live, then we will die. And the person, he did not listen to him and he did not follow his invitation. This is the evil invitation. And what he saw in the hereafter? That person, the pious one, he is in Jannah and the bad one is in hellfire. Allahu Akbar. Can you imagine if that person, he listened to him in dunya, what will happen to him? He will be in the middle of the hellfire with him. But the will of Allah and the ni'mah of Allah and the karam of Allah and the generous, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, very generous. He give the hidayah to that person to, and subhanAllah, not let him listen to that evil invitation. Subhanallah. So this is the ayat from Surah Safat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this story, so much lesson in it. that we have to be sure that we what kind of friends we are taking. If we are combined with the bad people, we might be influenced by them, and they might lead us to Jahannam, wa'iyadhu billah, to bid'ah, to innovation, to wrong doing, to bad deeds. All this one it might be. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning to us, please find the good companionship. After these verses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Al-Furqan, ayah number 27-29. I prepared the ayat for you, but the internet come down. I see if now come back, inshallah I will show you some of the translation. قال تعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتا ليتني لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. سبحان الله. In this ayat, ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه. In يوم القيامة, in that day, when is the ظالم will bite his own hands. Allahu Akbar. Allah did not mention this hand, all. He will be bited. Usually when a person has regret, he will bite one finger, or he bite two finger, three finger, but this person not one finger or two. He will bite his own hand completely, keep biting. Can you imagine how he look like? Why he's biting his hands? Why? Because he is in full of regret. He is regretting, deeply regretting. He keep biting. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. And he say, يَا لَيْتَنِي, I wish, I hope, I wish that تَخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا, I took the way of the messengers. يَا وَيْلَتَا, why on me? Why for me? He keep blaming and regretting. يَا وَيْلَتَا, لَيْتَنِي, I wished, لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا, I did not took a person as a khalil, a person as a close friend. لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا. لقد أضلني, he mislead me, he misguided me عن السبيل, in the right, from the right way. وكان الشيطان للإنسان خذولا, and الشيطان for the human being خذولا, he will be وَالْعَاذُ بِاللَّهِ mislead, misguided. He never, shaitan or devil, never ever fulfilled the promise for the human being. Brother, can you try if it's fix the internet? Inshallah, give to me. Inshallah. So, shaitan, whatever from the promise, he will never fulfill. He promised the believer, I will save you. He promised his servants whom follow shaitan, you will enjoy this dunya and you will enjoy in the akhirah. Don't worry. I will be with you. I will support you. I will help you. But what happened? In the hereafter, he said, قال تعالى in Surah Ibrahim, وقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم. الشيطان he will say, he's in the hellfire with his servants and with his follower and whomever follow him, all the devils from shaitan of jinn and from the shaitan of human being, they will be in jahannam wal'iyadhu billah. And they will say, inna Allah, indeed Allah promised you the truth and Allah fulfilled his promise, but I promise you false and I did not fulfill my promise, and you cannot blame me because I just invited you and you listen and you obey, so don't blame me but blame yourself. That's what Allah says in the Quran. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي إِنِّي كَفَرْتُ بِمَا أَشْرَكْتُمُونِ مِن قَبْلِ. Now I disbelieve in all the shirk, the one you committed for me. I disbelieve now. I'm out of this. But when he's saying this, after everything finished. And subhanAllah, here showing to us how the bad friends and the devil work together to mislead the ummah, mislead the truth, make the truth unclear, put so much cloud, put so much, what do you call it, hard things in front of the way of the true believer. So subhanAllah, this ayat really, it's awakening us to remember how evil the bad friends, and we have to avoid them. Another ayat, قوله تعالى سورة الزخرف, ayah number 37-39. And this ayah, subhanAllah, so much deep, direct to the point. قال تعالى, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم,
وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَصُدُّونَهُمْ عَنِ السَّبِيلِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَنَا قال يا ليت بيني وبينك بعد المشرقين فبئس القرين ولن ينفعكم اليوم إذ ظلمتم أنكم في العذاب مشتركون.
ما في إنترنت, ما في إنترنت, there's no internet. So in this ayat, قال تعالى وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ, whomever turn away from the remembrance of الرَّحْمَنِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا. Shaytan, one shaytan, he will be combined with him. فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ, he will be with him all the time. In the morning until night, subhanAllah, he's with, will be with him. وَإِنَّهُمْ وَإِنَّهُمْ شَيْطَانَ فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَصُدُّونَهُمْ عَنِ السَّبِيلِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. And this قَرِينٌ, this shaytan, he will mislead and misguide that person, and he thought he is in the right way, he is in the good state, he is in the right, he's in the truth, he's doing good. That's how shaitan decorate the haram. Whatever he do from haram, whatever he do from wrongdoing, that is a good, that's fantastic. What's wrong with that? It's good. We are civilized. So much they put now, so many big title in order to show what they are doing is okay, no problem. What's wrong with that? What's wrong with the riba? We have to invest our money, we have to improve our money, our financial, we have to support. The Muslim should be in the top of the ummah, so we have to take riba. Subhanallah al-Azim, riba is haram. zina, fornication, it's okay. This one is bring money, good. Ah, subhanAllah. Nah, every haram, the shaitan find a way for the people, it's okay. So this is, subhanAllah, the misguiding from shaitan. Bid'ah. Why you do this bid'ah innovation? This is not from the sunnah of Rasulullah. It's okay. I'm doing do good. I love Allah. Subhanallah. They start to create the people wrong understanding of the Quran and Sunnah. And wrong understanding from the right way or the way of truth. And this is the work of shaitan and the bad friends. حتى إذا جاءنا قال يا ليت بيني وبينك بعد المشرقين فبئس القرين. Subhanallah, but in Yawm al-Qiyamah, when he come, that Qareen, he will say, when he meet him in the hereafter, what he will say, he say, I wish that between you and between me and you, far distance as between the south and the east and the west. Allahu Akbar. بعد المشرقين. I wish that you are far away from me. I don't want to see you. Allahu Akbar. This is a... But what? After too late. وَلَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ إِذْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ فِي الْعَذَابِ مُشْتَرِكُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, both of you, because you did wrongdoing, because you did ظلم, ظلم to yourself, ظلم to others, this will not be benefit, both of you will be in punish. This is subhanAllah, how evil the bad friends, from shaitan or from the human being. SubhanAllah, here it's a give us reminder. I would like to put a note for ourselves. Why in our ummah now, the sihr and what do you call, the magic, the mass, wal'iyadhu billah, so much spread around among of the Muslims. This ayah is teaching us, نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانَ. A partner from the shaitan, he will be companion with him. And subhanAllah, why? Because they are in the haram. Some of them, wal'iyadhu billah, they become sick and what you call, the shaitan will touch them, they call mass. Okay? While he's doing haram, while he's drinking alcohol, while he's watching haram things, while he's taking drugs, this is very easy for the shaitan to attack this kind of people because they are away from Allah and they are away from the protection of the malaikat. So when they had these diseases, they will be worse and worse. So this is, subhanAllah, one of the negative part from the bad friends where it can lead. Answering the bad friends, it's a reason for all evils, wallahi. And avoiding the bad friends, it's a way for all goodness. SubhanAllah. Have you ever asked yourself, and now it's a good moment to ask yourself, who is my friends? Whom I hang with? Whom they are my partners and my companionship? Are they are from class A and plus, or they are from the worst? Are they are among of the good, whom they remind me always to be a better person, or they always drag me and bring me to the haram, and always make me far away from Allah? So here, it's very important question to ask ourselves. SubhanAllah, when you come regard the marriage, every single person, he will look carefully about his partner. Who she is? Is she is wealthy? Is she is good look? Is she is good behave? Good akhlaq, good manners? How much she earn? Who their her family, and they keep asking so much questions. And also the lady, she will ask so much question about her partner. How about your friend, the one you want to stay to be with him for longer life? You have to choose the right person. And not only me, I have to educate and discipline my children whom under my hand. This understanding based of the Quran and Sunnah. So when they understand, they have to select their friends, they will be safe from influence from that environment. Subhanallah, this really, really important to ask ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ يَخُوضُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا فَأَعْرُضْ عَنْهُمْ. O Prophet, O Muhammad, if you see the people talking about the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the bad way, أَعْرُضْ عَنْهُمْ, ignore them until they change the topic. So Allah teaching Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't be remain with those people talking evilness about the Quran. Even in the sake of da'wah. Subhanallah, this is a lesson for us, for ummah. Another hadith, qala Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, la tusahib illa mu'mina, wa la ya'kul ta'amaka illa taqi. Don't be friend except with the true believer. And no one eat your food except taqiyun, whom has the fearness of Allah. Rasul said, la tusahib, don't be companionship and friend, close friend, except to the believer who believe, mu'min. And وَلَا يَأْكُلْ طَعَامَكَ, and allow the person, allow the muttaqi, the one he fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to eat your food. Yani don't allow other people, just allow the muttaqin to invite them to your home and let them eat from your food whom they are have fearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is this? Give us wisdom. That is a lesson. Don't hang with anyone except with the believer. And don't allow to come your own home except who has a fearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is taqwa, who can improve your iman and faith and akhlaq. Another hadith, riwayat Abi Dawud wa Tirmidhi bi isnad al-hadith, qala Hasan, sahih, authentic hadith, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-mar'u ala deeni khalilih, falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil. Al-mar' means the person, ala deeni khalilih, in the person is on the faith or in the religion of his friend. So look who you are, whom your friend. Look whom your friend. A person, his deen, his religion, the same of his friend. The same of close friend, khalilihi, very companionship, his close friend. So look who you are choosing as a friend or as a close friend. More or less, the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give us amazing instruction that a person, if he hang with a smoker, he will be smoking. A person, he hang with the people, he drinking, they drink alcohol, soon or later he will be drink alcohol, or if he didn't drink alcohol, he will feel okay. He didn't feel it like it's really haram, it's really evil. Subhanallah. The person he hang with a person he doing bid'ah and shirk and kufr, he will do same or he will be like that things, enjoying these things. A person he has a friend and close a friend, he go to club and dance, sooner or later he will might go with him and join this wal'adhu billah haram way. So we have to be careful who we choose our close friend. Another hadith showing the relationship between the Muslims. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man ahabba lillah, whomever love, forsake of Allah. وأبغض لله and he hate for sake of Allah وأعطى لله and he give for sake of Allah ومنع لله and he avoid and he did not give for sake of Allah فقد استكمل الإيمان. He will be complete his إيمان. His إيمان will be complete. الله أكبر. He love for sake of Allah. He hate for sake of Allah. He give for sake of Allah. He don't give for sake of Allah. He will have completely إيمان. إيمان as a complete package. الله أكبر. And this hadith in صحيح الجامع. Look at لقمان الحكيم. We have a surah لقمان, is it? Revealed in the Quran showing that one person, his name لقمان, he was wise. He gives so much wisdom to his son. Mentioned in the Quran. And another wisdom also mentioned in some hadith. He said one time, يَا بُنَيَّ تَخَيَّرْ الْمَجَالِسْ عَلَىٰ عَيْنَيْكِ يعني choose the right setting where to sit. With where we were to hang out. If you see a people remembering Allah, sit with them. Sit with them. فَإِن كُنْتَ عَالِمًا نَفَعَكَ عِلْمُكَ. If you are knowledgeable, your knowledge will benefit you. And if you not knowledgeable, they will teach you. Subhanallah. And if you find people يلحون ويلعبون, they are playing, they are wasting their time, and they will not, those people, they will not remembering Allah, don't sit with them. Because if you are a scholar or if you are knowledgeable, your knowledge is not benefit you. And if you are jahil, if you are ignorant, if you don't know, they will increase your ignorance. They will increase your ignorance. Allahu Akbar. سبحان الله لعل الله أن يطلع عليهم بنقمة فتصيبك معهم. And Allah might look at them in angry, then Allah will be angry from you all. So don't hang with those people. Here a question. Ask ourselves, how many fathers and mother ask their children, who you hang with, who is your close friends, what their names are, they are really doing salat, are they really love Islam, are they really know la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah? Have you ever think to follow up with your children and know who they are, their friend? You don't know when they come out from the home. You never ask yourself. They might hang with their friends reading wal'adhu billah haram books, watching haram movies, smoking behind your back. Subhanallah, doing all bad things. Allahu Akbar. A story from girl, she said, from the year 4, can you imagine year 4 in the school? She start reading sexual books. And she start smoking without awareness of her parents. Were they her father and mother? Or uncle or cousin or family? Nobody follow up, check, help her, advise her, guide her. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. If your son or daughter hang with friend whom they are smoking, soon or later they will be smoke like them. If your son or your daughter or someone under your hand, your nephew, whatever, they hang with the friends, they are taking drugs, soon or late or later they will take drugs. Going for haram concert, they will do the same. You know or you don't know, they will do. So we have to educate and discipline them. teach them what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rules. Allah rules. Can you imagine if your children hanging with the friends, they deny salat? Trust me, soon or later they will deny the salah, or they stop some of the salat. Maybe in front of you they do one salah, and the rest of the day they will not pray at all. Who is responsible? Yes, your children, they have responsibility, but also you have also responsibility. Subhanallah, we have to think and share and warn. One time I attend Khutbatul Jumu'ah. Wallahi, it was really scary from the beginning of the khutbah until the end, talking about one story. True story, and the person he wrote it, he wrote the story, he is the one, subhanAllah, telling about himself. He has a parents, they doesn't care much. They can go anytime outside the home. They never ask. So that one of the member of this family, he was a boy, and when they success in the school, they went to the behind the house in the garage. They said, let's have a party, and they put the music and start dancing, wasting, smoking, whatever, like as a type of enjoyment. And one of these bad friends, he put drugs in the tea, of a cup of the tea of all of them, and he liked it. Then he asked, let's come have a party, every time have a party, and until the son or that one of the member of the family, he become drugs addict, and he failed in the school. One time, who found him? His own sister. She found him taking that drugs, and she threatened him, she will tell the parents. That member of family, other than to repent to Allah and stop, he was angry and stressed and worried. And who went to counsel? He went to his bad friends to give consultation, other than to go to the pious person or salih or sheikh or imam, whatever. He went to the bad friend, the leader, who is, what they call it, give the drugs, sell the drugs. And he asked him, I am in situation. What is the situation? What is the problem? He said, my sister found out that I am taking drugs. Oh my God, if she tell you, father, he will beat you, he will tell the police about us, we all will be in trouble. So what we should do? The best way, make your sister fall in drugs. Allahu Akbar. No, and he angry and he fight with him. He went back and he start, shaking. He want drugs. He said, I will not give you until you do what I told you. Then he start put the drugs inside the cup until his sister become drugs addict. Wal-iyadhu billah. Look at the shaitan, the bad friends. After that, did not stop the story here. One time he went to buy the drugs from the drugs dealer. He said, I will not give you until you give me your sister to hang out with me. What are you saying? Fight with him, bash each other. And he told his sister after that, we need drugs and this and this. She said, it's okay, I go hang with him. I will not do anything. I need the drugs. And the brother fight with the sister, and she went out with him. He took her as a girlfriend. Later on, suddenly, wal-iyadhu billah, the drugs dealer and with his sister, they went with the car with high speed, and they had accident, and both of them died. The police call, come, see, the family found his own daughter, no hijab, nothing. Before she come out from the home, she has hijab. After out, the parents doesn't know what is going on. Subhanallah. When the father saw his own daughter in this look, wearing sexy clothes, died, and she's in drugs, wal'iyadhu billah, out of shocking, he died. He has a heart attack and he died. And the mother, she had a disease, like a paralysis. And the one he wrote a story. He said, "I ask Allah every day to take my life back. I want a suicide. I cannot see. I am the one killed my family. Because of what? Bad friends. Subhanallah, very, very dangerous. And like this story, maybe you know more. And you see our society, how this new generation, the look of Islam, no more. They try to act like kuffar. You know why? Because they have a bad friends. They influenced by them. They want to be like a, you know, famous singer. They put ring in their ear. They want, some of the children, they change to male to look like female. From where they learn these things? From the bad friends. Subhanallah. So we have to educate our children. This is our wealth. We have to show them how in Islam haram to hang out with the bad friends. I want to show you one story. It's in the clip. But subhanAllah, the internet did not work in this, I don't know. True story. A person, alhamdulillah, young man, he repent to Allah. Alhamdulillah. He repent, he changed his life, he start praying, he start do salah. The bad friends keep invite him, come to the olden days, come, let's hang out, let's do all the haram. He said, no way I do. They try all the hard on him, they did not success. One time, look, the shaitan, the bad friends, they very smart. They very, very smart. They came and they said, we want to travel one camp and we want an imam with us who lead the salah in front of us. And they start talking so sweet words. Mistakenly, he followed them. And they went to the camp. When they arrived the place where they already prepared everything, they paid money, beautiful girl, sexy one, to come with alcohol to serve him. And she come with the fitna was so high, he start drinking alcohol, 1, 2 cups, 3 cups, until become drunk, and he fool in fornication and zina with her. They paid her money to success. This is all this amount for you, as long he will be come back to the olden days. The shocking story, you know what happened? Wallahi, is shocking. After he did everything, he slept, his friend came, woke him up, he's dead. Wal'iyadhu billah. He died in the state of drinking and fornicating. Wal'iyadhu billah. This is how evil the bad friends. This story is true. Happened. Subhanallah. So we have to be careful from bad friends. Tell me, who is spreading the bid'ah, innovation in the ummah? The bad people. And they calling da'wah for the bid'ah every day. And they fight so hardly, the people, the one they have the truth. So whomever hang with them, they might misguide them, mislead them. So here we have to give awakening. And from whatever we hear not clear, put it in the scale of Al-Quran and Sunnah. If Al-Quran and Sunnah approved, alhamdulillah. If Al-Quran Sunnah did not approve, whatever is beautiful rejected. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. سبحان الله. Islam is complete. Doesn't need any new way or changing. So here to show the people of Jannah, they understood and they understood how evil the bad friends, and from there they always look every day, look for the good people who will improve their iman. If one time he did not go to masjid to do salat, they will remind them, give them reminder. When the time he's planning to do haram, no brother, this is not really right, he will give awakening. No sister, this is not right, this is not proper way of dress, this is not really good to chat and cheat, this is not right way of doing this and that. Always remind each other. This is what we really need in our ummah, to establish companionship or companionship from the salihin, from the mu'mineen, from mukhlisin, from muttaqin, from khashirin, from dhakirin, from sa'imin, from taliyin al-Quran, hafidhin al-Quran. Here inshaAllah our iman will be strong bi'idhnillah. Hadith al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, al-mu'minu mir'atu akhi, the believer is like a mirror for his, the other believer. So how can I see my hair is look okay or not when I look at to myself in the mirror? Also, how I know myself, I am in right way or bad way or good way or evil way? My friend is there to remind me and correct me. Here inshallah we need to improve ourselves inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا وأحسن الله إليكم. Inshallah we continue the series of the description of the people of paradise inshallah for the coming classes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefit us from whatever we hear and from whatever we learn. We wish Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the iman and hidayah and good friends until we meet him while we are in the good states. And lastly, I would like to remind you, the good friend, even in the moment of death, he will remind you La ilaha illallah, which will be achieved by this word Al-Jannah. So inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength and the ability to say La ilaha illallah before we die. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ya rabbal alameen wa ya arhamar rahimeen an taghfir lana ajma'een. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أصلح قلوبنا وأصلح ذرياتنا وأصلحنا بما أصلحت عبادك الصالحين. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.